Hey, what's going on? Welcome back to The Drop. I'm Tahir Moore.
And I'm MegScoop. And LeBron James is fired up.
Yeah.
You hear me?
Big dog status.
He's angry. He finally fired back at former NBA player Charles Barkley because Charles always talks so negatively about him.
He talks shit. That's what Charles Barkley does, fam.
So last night after the Cleveland Cavaliers lost to the Dallas Mavericks, LeBron talked to ESPN's Dave McMenamin off the record. He called Charles a hater, which he is.
Yeah.
He's definitely a hater. And he went on this long rant and let him have it. LeBron said, I'm not gonna let him disrespect my legacy like that. I'm not the one who threw somebody through a window.
Preach.
I never spit on a kid.
Come on, somebody.
I never had unpaid debt in Las Vegas. I never said I'm not a role model.
And then he went on to say, all I've done my entire career is represent the NBA the right way. 14 years, never got in trouble, respected the game. Print that. I'm tired of biting my tongue. There's a new sheriff in town.
What?
Okay, fam.
Okay. I'm proud of him because LeBron is, he's always been picture perfect, the model NBA player. And for him to just be like, nah, you're not gonna do that to my legacy, bro. Nah.
Honestly, guys, I've never been a huge LeBron or Kobe fan.
Because you're a hater, Charles Barkley.
That is fine. I came up in the era of Michael Jordan, and I didn't like the fact that they were comparing these guys to Michael Jordan. Still don't like Kobe like that, but I cannot deny his skills, all right? It was just the hater in me. I gotta be completely honest with you guys. And when it comes to LeBron, I didn't like the fact that they were calling him King James before he even set foot on the court.
It goes well with his name.
I don't care, and I didn't like it. But I gotta be completely honest, guys. I would be completely remiss if I didn't admit the fact that this guy is literally a legend, okay? For someone to go down to Miami, put a team on his back, and take them to the championship, ridiculous. And then to come back home from his original city, okay, the city that burned his jersey.
Spit on him.
Right.
Spit on his jersey, ass.
Raise the economy. Literally, bars downtown and restaurants downtown said they saw anywhere from a 30% to a 200% increase in sales.
When LeBron,
200%!
When he came back, that's amazing.
That is amazing. He created jobs, he boosted the economy. He is the living, walking poster child for what a black athlete could be, okay? He stayed with the high school sweetheart. He's very active in his kid's life. He's helping the economy. He's giving people an opportunity to live their dreams.
Yeah.
His success and wealth, you don't get any better than LeBron James, ladies and gentlemen.
Nope.
And you cannot continue to hate on his greatness. Even if you don't like him as a person, you cannot hate on his greatness or his legacy. All right, squad, so we want to hear from you.
How should Charles Barkley respond? Put it in the comments below.
And guess what, guys? MTV2 done messed up and gave us a show. Woo, woo, woo,
woo. All Def Digital has a new show, and it's called ADD TV. It premieres this Friday, February 3rd at 11:30 p.m. Make sure you guys go and check that out.
That's right, we invading your space, fam. You know what time it is.
It's the comment of the day.
Hey, when I stop, you stop, man.
You're not the boss of me.
Comment of the day refers to yesterday's video about the SAG Award speech is quickly turning political, and it goes to Sterling Miller. He says, Denzel looks like that one teacher that's the hardest on you because he believes in you.
Thanks, Denzel, I'm here because of you.
We see you, fam. As always, guys, remember to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. I'm Tahir Moore.
And I'm MegScoop. We'll see you tomorrow right here on The Drop. Oh, whoa, what?
It's terrible. Just terrible.
Not terrible.